Hello, and welcome to this complete step-by-step guide, where we will learn how to reply to a message on Discord using an Android device. Whether you're chatting in a private DM, a group message, or a large community server, replying properly helps keep conversations clear and easy to follow, especially when the chat is active and messages are flying by quickly. Let's walk through everything, from opening the app to replying to specific messages with explanations of the different reply methods. Before we begin, you might wonder, why not just type the message directly? When you reply to someone using the reply feature, Discord links your response to the original message. This keeps things organized and avoids confusion, especially in group chats or fast-moving servers. Make sure you have the Discord app installed and updated from the Google Play Store. Then tap the Discord icon to open the app. Log in with your account if you're not already signed in. For DMIs, tap the person's name in the messages section. For server, choose the server, then select the appropriate channel. Scroll through the conversation until you find the exact message you want to reply to. It can be from you or someone else. Once you've found the message, tap and hold on it. Don't just tap once. This will bring up a pop-up menu with several options like reply, copy text, pin message, mark unread, report, and others, depending on your role. Permissions from the list, choose reply. Now you'll see the original message quoted above the text input box. This lets you know your message will be directly linked to the one you're replying to. Go ahead and type your response in the text box. It can be anything, a message, emoji, link, or GIF. Once you're done, tap the send icon paper, plain to reply. Your reply will now appear with the original message above it, so everyone can see what you were responding to, super helpful. After replying, others will see your message as a threaded reply. They can tap the original message shown in your reply to jump directly to it. And this is great in long chats to keep context clear. That's it. So, I think that's enough for this tutorial. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment sections below. And if this video helped you out, don't forget to give thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more tutorial video. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next video.